what they'll do. One of these days these boots are gonna walk all over you. Are you ready, Boots? Start walking.
Johnny Sexton, this is Johnny Sexton's World. FBI team raided the home of a Georgia couple over the U.S. Capitol riot. They held her daughter, who was 11 years old, at gunpoint. This is what the dad says, and you know what? You almost can't not believe this. So, you know, things that you read, oh, you know, we would never do that. But we do. FBI agents allegedly held an 11-year-old girl at gunpoint during a raid at an Atlanta-area farm owned by a couple who reportedly have ties to a far-right militia group. In an incident that is just now emerging in the media, 40 federal agents traveling in four armored vehicles showed up at Covington, Georgia-area home of Donnie and Anne Marie Hyatt on the morning of August 10th, with a search warrant apparently as part of an ongoing investigation into, of course, the January 6th riot at the U.S. Capitol. First of all, it was not a riot. It was basically, it was sort of a riot, trespassing riot. It was not an insurrection, as they call it. You want to see an insurrection? Look over in Afghanistan yesterday. That's an insurrection. This was not an insurrection. You want an example? Just take a look at what you did in Afghanistan. That's an insurrection. All right? So now they go into the farmhouse. So Donnie Hyatt, he tells the people that his 11-year-old daughter, they held her at gunpoint. He said his daughter had laser sights trained on her and is pretty shaken by the experience. Well, of course. So she still shakes when she talks about it. It's only 6 days later. So he claims he was there. They don't deny being there, okay? Donnie Hyatt and his wife attended the January 6th Stop and Steal rally in Washington, D.C., but he says they didn't enter the Capitol building and described the breach as a real dumb decision. Instead, he claims he was monitoring what was going on with a police scanner. I don't even know anybody that knows anybody that went in. So they took all of his computers, his electrical equipment, his daughter's tablet, cell phones. They took all kinds of stuff. This is what a police state is like. And if you really want to know what a police state is like, Dateline, sometime around Saturday, only hours after Minnesota GOP operative Anton Lazaro posted online DNA evidence that allegedly shows Rep. Ilhan Omar was once married to her brother, the FBI busted him. Test results state that there's a 99.9999998% chance. Why did they get that 8 at the end? That Omar and her second husband, Ahmed Elmi, now her ex-husband, are siblings, according to an analysis by British company Endeavor DNA Laboratories. But before Lazaro could share the results with the media, he was arrested on underage sex trafficking charges and jailed pending a court hearing, which was today. That's odd, huh? This has been a rumor for a long time. The left debunks it as a conspiracy theory. Of course, your politifact checkers say it's not true. But now, that DNA evidence that was put up online was pulled down within hours after his arrest, which seems kind of amazing. You think that you're living in a police state? I'm not sure. I don't know. Take a look. Everyone's free. You got freedom to do whatever you want. You don't. This is becoming a third world police state. There is no doubt about it. Wear masks. We're making you wear the masks. Get your vaccine. We're making you get the vaccine. Just think of what they tell you with the vaccine. Hey, you know what? We've been nice long enough, okay? We made it a volunteer thing. We made it, you know, gave you money, gave you ice cream, and still half of you didn't take it. You know, guess what? Easy days are over. We're coming for you. You know, I always thought people were crazy. Thought they were nuts stocking up on guns. And guess what? I'm thinking about it now. They stocked up on guns. You know what? They weren't stupid. This government, if they happen to keep in charge somehow, they're coming for us. They're coming for you. They're coming for me. They're coming for all of us. Don't know how, don't know why, but they're going to get you. You got to march in lockstep with them, but they're going to get you. Now, take a look at this guy. This is their go-to move, underage sex trafficking. What did they go after Matt Gaetz for? Matt Gaetz. Remember Matt Gaetz, congressman from Florida? Sure, they got him. They said, oh, yeah, you brought an underage girl over to Russia or something with him, put him up in a hotel, all kinds of stuff, without any evidence. All they did was supposedly they took this girl's word, who recanted her whole story a couple of weeks later. Guess what? Gaetz is in the news, all over the news, with his underage girl stories. And then when she recants her story, guess what's not on the news? The story about Gaetz girl recanting her story. Never shows up. They leave him out, their reputation sullied. I didn't even know it until I spoke to someone. That's how ridiculous this is. They're coming to get us. If they can get anyone, if they can get these politicians, they're going to come to get anyone that they can. That's why this show is on. This is why Johnny Sexton's world is on the air. We're here to try to enlighten. Like I said, anyone can tell you what you see on Fox. Anyone can tell you what you see on, God, why would you watch MSNBC or CNN, the comedy shows. But anyone can tell you what you see. Like I said, we are going deeper on this podcast. Deeper and deeper. We're going to go as deep as we can get. It's going to be cutting. It's not going to feel good sometimes. But like I said, I'm a tough love type of guy. That's what you're going to get from me, tough love. I don't care how you feel. You're going to catch us all over the internet. You can pick up, if you pick up the podcast now, I don't know why I'm telling you this, but you can pick us up on a bunch of different podcast hosts. We got, holy cow, We got a whole bunch of them. So many, you know, you wouldn't even, We're on Podcast Addict. We're on Pod Chaser. If you're over in India for some reason, I have no idea, but you were on Geosavan, Giosaavn. We're on CastBox. We're on Deezer, Deezer. We're on Podcast Addict. Oh, I already said that, I think. We'll be on iHeartRadio. We're pending there. We're also pending on Google Podcasts, pending on Amazon once they send me my paperwork. Apple Podcasts we're on. Spreaker Podcasts we're on. Spotify we're on. So we're on all those different ones. I found out one today that I got to get the name again of it that we're not on, but I'll find it and get us on there. But if you guys know of any platforms that you'd want us to be on or that we're not on, that you have more, that you're more comfortable with listening to the show, let me know. It is johnnysextonsworld@gmail.com. You can get me on Twitter, hashtag johnnysextonsworld, or even the Johnny Sexton, T-H-E Johnny Sexton on Twitter. You can also pick us up on Facebook.com/johnnysextonsworld. You can get us all over the place. We're trying to be trying to get everything out there for you guys. Well, it's been a great night. Again, it's a sad, sad day for America because we were beaten soundly by the Afghanis on this. And unfortunately, we have a terrible leader right now, but we have to band together to oust this clown and his henchmen and his gang of Pelosi, Schumer, and all those people. So whatever state you're in, work to get these people out of office or else they're going to replace them with someone much worse. You know, Schumer's worried. You know why Schumer's worried? Because Andrea Ocasio-Cortez may be running against him for his New York State Senator. And guess what? The political machine's in place. Just like Pelosi said with Gavin Newsom. Gavin Newsom is, you know, he's up for the recall out in California. And she goes, well, you know, the political machine's in place. I got my political machine working on getting him reelected. I'm like, oh, what kind of crap is that? Well, she's Gavin Newsom's aunt anyway. But, you know, the guy sucks. You know, most of these people, the Democrats in office right now, suck. They got an agenda that we have not ever seen the likes of. We don't want to see the likes of it. We want our freedoms and our liberties, and they are quicker than I thought, taking them away from us. This is Johnny Sexton, Johnny Sexton's World. I'll have another one up in a couple of days. Thanks for listening, everyone. Bye-bye.
Listen to you, good-natured ladies. Come and sit smiling up at me. And backward boys abroad would linger till after three. And I can see what's never seen, the greatest show that's ever been. Audience is playing for me. A group of strangers turned to friends, acting naturally. They laugh and cry and take me just where I want to be. And when I think of times I've flown the highest, they were times I've known. The audience was playing for me. I don't want to be famous, don't want to work in big homes. I might even be hiding fame and fortune call. But if I can't see just who I'm singing to, how will you know I'm still singing them all for you? Just to keep the audience.